Welcome to another video on multiplying polynomials. This video is entitled Special Products, and the goals of this video are to identify and find special products of polynomials. This video does assume that you've already watched the video entitled Multiplying Polynomials. So in the last video, we did multiply binomials. However, there's a method called the FOIL method to multiply two binomials together in the form of the quantity A plus B and the quantity C plus D. And that method is as follows. The first product would be the product of the first terms, or A times C. Because it's the first term in each binomial, they label that F, or first. Next, it would be the outer terms, or A times D. You can see it's the leftmost term and the rightmost term, so they call it the outer terms. The next product would be the inner terms, so B times C are considered the inner terms. And the last terms, b times d, would be the last terms in each binomial factor. Now, I'm not a real big fan of this acronym because as long as you can remember to multiply each term in the first times each term in the second, that'll apply whether we're multiplying binomials, trinomials, and so on. But the FOIL method only works for two binomials. So if you like it, you can use it. But remember, it only applies to multiplying two binomials together. Here's another example below. X times x would be the first terms. X times 1 would be the outer terms. 2 times x would be the inner terms. And 2 times 1 would be the last terms, which does simplify to x squared plus 3x plus 2. That's FOIL. Let's go ahead and take a look at another example. So we're going to multiply this x times both terms in the second. Well, there's the f and there's the o for first terms and outer terms. Then we'll multiply negative 5 times both terms. This would be the inner product, this would be the last product. So we have x times x, or x squared. X times a positive 7, that'd be plus 7x. Negative 5 times x would be negative 5x. And negative 5 times positive 7 equals negative 35. Combining our like terms, we have x squared plus 2x minus 35. So as you can see, it's pretty much the same as the last video with this new acronym that you can use if you wish. But personally, I choose to not use it because I prefer to view it as a pattern of multiplication. So here we multiply this 2x times both terms in the second, and then we multiply the negative 5 times both terms in the second. So you can see we'll have four products. First product, 2x to the first times 3x to the first equals 6x squared. 2x times negative 1, negative 2x. Negative 5 times 3x, negative 15x. And negative 5 times negative 1 equals positive 5. Once again, combine the like terms. Our final product, 6x squared minus 17x plus 5. Next is a special product. The product of the sum and difference of the same two terms is the square of the first term minus the square of the second term. You can see if we have the quantity a plus b times the quantity a minus b, this will be equal to a squared minus b squared. This is a nice shortcut if you recognize the pattern, but again, if you don't, that's fine. As long as you remember how to multiply polynomials together, the end result will be the same. This is just a shortcut. So let's do this one the long way and then recognize the pattern. We multiply this x times both terms in the second. Then we multiply the 7 times both terms in the second. X times x equals x squared. X times a negative 7 would be negative 7x. A positive 7 times x would be plus 7x. And positive 7 times negative 7 would equal negative 49. So really what's special about this product is that the two like terms will always be opposites when we have the sum and difference of the same two terms. Therefore, the result equals x squared minus 49. Notice the first term is x squared and the second term is 7 squared, and it will always be a difference. Let's try another one of those. Again, if you recognize this pattern where the two terms are the same, one's a sum and one's a difference, this will equal the first term squared, or x squared. It's always minus, and 2 squared would be 4. However, if you're ever not sure, we can just do it the long way. X times x times 2 negative 2 times x, negative 2 times positive 2. And just to check this, we would have x squared plus 2x minus 2x minus 4. And we can see positive 2x and negative 2x are opposites. Those cancel, which result in our special product. So on this last example, let's go ahead and just take the shortcut. We notice that the terms are the same. One's a sum, one's a difference. So the first term of the product will be the first term squared minus the second term squared. This would give us 16x squared minus 9. So you can see it does save some work. But again, if you're not sure, work it out the long way and you'll never miss it. Next, let's take a look at the product of a polynomial squared. Now in this case, remember there are no shortcuts. The steps will be write out the factors being multiplied, multiply each term in one polynomial by each term in the other, and then simplify and combine like terms. The key here to remember is there are no shortcuts. So x plus 6 squared is equal to x plus 6 times x plus 6. So we multiply this x times both of these terms, and then multiply the 6 times both of the terms in the second. So this will give us x squared. Now notice the next product would be 6x, and the next product would also be 6x. 6x plus 6x would be 12x, and 6 times 6 is 36. So many textbooks do give these formulas, but I'm not a big fan of them. What they say is, if you have a sum or difference squared, it's equal to the first term squared plus or minus double the product of the first and the second plus the second squared. So what that's saying here is that the first term is x squared. The next term is 2 times x times 6, which is 12x. And the last term would be 6 squared or 36. To me, that's just way too much to remember. We are just going to multiply it out like we normally do and pretty much disregard these two formulas. So again, the key here is to remember there are no shortcuts to squaring this. We have to write it out as 9x minus 1 times 9x minus 1, and then find the product. So we would have 9x times 9x, or 81x squared. 9x times negative 1, negative 9x, and then we get another negative 9x. And negative 1 times negative 1 is positive 1. Combining our like terms, we have negative 18x plus 1. And let's end by multiplying a binomial times a trinomial. And this is one of the main reasons why I don't like memorizing special formulas. As long as you can remember that we have to multiply each term in the first times each term in the second, we'll never go wrong. We have three products. When we multiply this x times each term in the second. And then we have three more. When we multiply this 3 times each term in the second. So that's all we really have to remember. So let's find these products. X times 2x squared would be 2x cubed. X times a negative 5x would be minus 5x squared. And x times 12 plus 12x. Because there are so many terms, I am going to write the next product in vertical form. So 3 times 2x squared would be 6x squared. I'll write this under the other x squared term. And then 3 times a negative 5x would be negative 15x. So I write minus 15x. And lastly, 3 times 12 is 36. Again, this facilitates combining like terms. We'd have 2x cubed plus x squared minus 3x and plus 36. Okay, I hope you found this video helpful. Again, hopefully you realize this is pretty much just like the other video, even though most textbooks do entitle this a lesson of special products.